The four young victims of the hostage crisis that ended late Monday night in Orlando, Florida, have been identified as siblings. Family attorney Walter Beninati identified the children as Orion Lopez, 12, Lilia Lopez, 10, Aiden Lindsay, 6 and 22-month-old Dove Lindsay as the children killed by Gary Wayne Lindsay Jr. Lindsay is the father of the two youngest children. The mother is in just complete shock, Beninati tells People of Lindsay's girlfriend who fled the apartment shortly before he took the children hostage at gunpoint. Right now she is angry and that will turn to grief that nobody can even fathom. Beninati described Orion as an overachiever who loved video games. Orion was a very bright young kid, he says about the middle schooler. Lilia, an elementary school student, loved to play with friends and loved Disney World, he says. Aiden, Beninati says, loved to play dinosaurs. Dove was just a young beautiful boy who loved to play, he adds. Beninati, who set up a GoFundMe page to help pay for the children's funeral. These beautiful babies never hurt anyone. It is a tragic ending to a night of horror, Beninati wrote on the page. Want to keep up with the latest crime coverage? Click here to get breaking crime news, ongoing trial coverage and details of intriguing unsolved cases in the True Crime Newsletter. The tragedy culminated when police discovered the bodies of the four children and Lindsay, 35, inside the Westbrook apartments on Eagles Mere Drive late Monday after a 24-hour standoff. All of apparent gunshot wounds. Police had attempted to negotiate the safe release of the children after officers arrived at the apartment at 11:45 p.m. Sunday night following a domestic violence call, but to no avail. A spokesperson from the Orlando Police Department told People that the incident began when a woman called police and reported that Lindsay had physically abused her. Beninati alleges that the woman, the children's mother, had been kicked in the head by Lindsay and ran out of the house. Beninati says the children were locked in the rooms at the time. He told the Orlando Sentinel, "Some may question why she ran out of that building, but nobody can know what she was going through, what horror she was feeling. In fairness to her, nobody can imagine taking the life of precious young children, which is what happened here," he continued. "The children's mother never thought in a million years he would hurt the kids," says Beninati. "It is tragic. It is an unspeakable act. Nobody could imagine it was going to end up this way." Related, four children dead after 24-hour Orlando hostage standoff before gunman kills himself when officers arrived at the scene. Lindsay opened fire on them, shooting officer Kevin Valencia, who is currently in critical condition, Orlando Police Chief John Mina said. The shooting preceded a 24-hour standoff in which Lindsay barricaded himself in the apartment with the four children and police tried to negotiate with him. According to Orlando police, SWAT teams and negotiators attempted to resolve the situation without further violence. More than 40 officers were on the scene, and the nearby apartments were evacuated. It was the that rocked America's most storied political family and changed the course of presidential history. People's first ever podcast, Cover Up, dives into the Chappaquiddick and attempts to piece together what happened in the hours after Ted Kennedy's car went over a narrow wooden bridge, killing his passenger, Mary Jo Kopechne. Subscribe now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, or wherever podcasts are available. Lindsay was allegedly on a suspended sentence at the time of the shooting. He was afraid to go back to prison, says Beninati. Authorities expressed their sadness about the violent end to the standoff. As you know, the Orlando Police Department and the Orange County Sheriff's Department have been working very hard during this long day to bring this situation to a peaceful resolution. Unfortunately, it has a very tragic and sad ending, Mina told reporters.